Now you see it in the healing phase, but the patient originally didn't have any teeth on the lower jaw, and on the upper jaw he had a couple of implants in the frontal area that you'll see that later on we just took out with the bridge. It happens. He had a...
Wait, you took the implants out?
Yeah, took the implants out. He had PFM crowns on those implants, and he had a denture, a partial denture on for the other teeth, and now he'll have a bridge.
You added those implants?
Yeah, so we've added on the lower jaw 8 implants, and on the upper jaw 6 implants. And with these implants, it'll be 8 implants for a jaw. In the first phase for making a restoration for those cases, before we extract the teeth, the patient still have his 4 frontal teeth, and he have some partial denture for the other teeth. So he can chew, he can have some function. In this case, the first thing that we want to do is we don't touch the teeth. We take impressions with those teeth, with scan abutments on the other implants. Then we take out the scan abutments and give him back his old denture. When we'll take out those crowns and we know that the implants will go out with those crowns, we already want to have some kind of bridge. We don't want to send the patient home without any teeth. So we took impressions on those kind of abutments, with scan the scan abutments, and then we need to know what is the vertical dimension of his occlusion. So we've added composite material on the lower scan abutments. We define the vertical dimensions, and we scan this composite material also in this occlusion. We know that this will be the height of the teeth for his lower jaw, and for his upper jaw probably will have a little bit smaller, but we can see in the anatomy of the face that his height is good for him, but maybe the proportions here that you can see, the upper teeth are a little bit bigger, the smaller, the lower teeth are a little bit too small. Maybe his occlusion line won't be as it is now, but somewhere a little bit higher. Depends on the smile line, depends on a lot of anatomic factors that you look at the patient later on, but this is the vertical dimension.
I see all the scan abutments are multi-unit level.
Yeah, we used all of the scan abutments on the multi-unit level. We screwed the scan abutments. For this part, we just inserted on top of the multi-unit healing caps and until the bridges will be ready. Now, when we got the bridges, you can see that the bridges are without any implants in the frontal area because we know that the implants will go out. We know that the implants are not osteointegrated with inflammation. There are a lot of problems.
What, the body just rejected them?
Yeah, the body rejected the implants.
A decade?
It's hard to tell when, but the body rejected, there is inflammation, and we'll take the implants out with the crowns, and in the same meeting, we'll mount the new bridge, the new teeth, on all those implants. So in here you can see the bridge. We took out the bridge, and with the bridge, one of the implants just went out as easy as it can be.
And the other one you just...
No, the other one probably left there. You can see the abutment.
Oh, I see.
With the cement on the abutment.
Still,
yeah. No, it is what it is. You can, if the implant's fine, you can change the abutment to another multi-unit and make another impression. It's not really a problem.
But the left one, the right, I mean, his right implant, frontal implant, just...
Yeah, you don't even need to extract the implant. You just take out and it goes...
With the bridge.
In here you can see the occlusion. We made the upper teeth a little bit smaller and the lower teeth a little bit higher because it is a smile line. And we still have some inflammation where his older implants were. So right now we need to wait for the healing process to be completed. And what you can see that in the after the healing process was completed, we have a space in the area where it was inflamed, where he had some implants and now he doesn't have those implants. So the bridge is fine, everything's fine. You can see that the central line, the smile, the patient is very satisfied with the bridge. He's very mabsut. And now we just need to correct this space. So what do we need to do? One of the things we can make impressions all over again. We can take out the bridge, insert scan abutments, take everything, make another design, but this design is good. So why taking another impressions? So what we want to do, what we can do, is we can pour some material between the bridge and the gingiva. We'll fill this gap, and then we can scan the material that we've added. And then because we have the same design already in the computer, we can mount both designs one on top of the another and add a little bit more material where we had space in this bridge.
So you're using this bridge and then you added material scanning this bridge again.
Exactly.
And producing a new bridge.
Yes, we've added material to the same bridge on the same impressions on everything that we did. We don't change the design at all, just making it a little bit longer. It's something that you can do with CADCAM manually if you have a PFM or, I don't know, making from any different method, it's a problem. Because you need to make new models, you need to have everything all over again. We've added material on those teeth. We took out the bridge and we scanned the material that we've added. So now we can take the 3D model of this bridge, mount on the original bridge. We know how much material we need to add to close this gap.
Composite is an amazing material. Yeah. Right? You do everything with it.
You can use the plastilina also.
So it's easy as it sounds. You just added a strip of composite. Cured.
It doesn't matter what type of material you use. You can use every material that can harden.
Yeah, I mean, any material you cure it, then you take it out and just scan it.
Exactly,
and that's all. With a desktop scanner and print it.
Or with the intraoral scanner, just scan the bridge itself.
And this is
the second temporary bridge. You can see that this gap is closed. We don't have any problems with the gap between the teeth and the gingiva. Right now, what we need to do is we need to make a design that's suitable for
the patient itself.
It's suitable for the patient, but for not a provisional bridge, but a permanent bridge. In this case, we want to make from zirconia. So we had temporary restorations. We've added composite material on top of the bridge, the upper bridge, because we wanted to close the space. We have all the information that we need now to make a permanent bridge, because we have the original impressions that we took. The impressions are good. So now, after the healing process, we've made a new temporary bridge and we're sure that this bridge is fine. It's great, because now we can make from all of the information that we gathered in the process, we can make a permanent bridge. We can make this bridge from zirconia. And this is what we did. So in zirconia, because the height of the teeth is very large, we've added some gingiva color glaze on top of the upper bridge because it can be seen in when he smiles.
You added quite a lot of glaze.
Yeah, it's quite a big teeth. And it's smaller than what he had before.
You did it in the clinic, right? The glazing?
Yeah, we did the glazing in the pink color. We've added chair side. And we cemented all the sleeves in the mouth. And still you can see that because the big span between the implants, we didn't saw on the temporal bridges that there was some inaccuracies, because when you have a bridge, a temporary bridge, a provisional bridge from PMMA, you can, it's easier to fit the bridge. It will look like passive, because you just tie the bridge onto the implants. But then when you make a zirconia bridge, a bridge from a hard material that is not that flexible like a PMMA in this case, you're starting to see some small inaccuracies that in the end will affect the longevity of the bridge. So in this case, when we cemented the sleeves, we saw that one of the sleeves got a little bit out. It can be because it's a bridge with a big span. Maybe there was some kind of problem in one of the processes that we had. Maybe it was in the scanning process. And still, even though we had a problem, we can still overcome the problem, because we cement the sleeves in the mouth. The sleeves are cementable. Later on, we can give to the technician or ourselves, close the cap between the sleeve and the bridge, and we'll have a passively cemented, passively fitted bridge on the multi-units that we had, that it won't be this passive if we didn't do this this way.
So it's a common thing that occurs.
It's a common thing that occurs. The biggest problem why sometimes we don't want to do this is because we want to get from the technician the perfect bridge with cement sleeve, just screw it and that's all. But in many cases it's a problem and we can't do this. We still have some inaccuracies that we need to overcome. We need to know that we have some problems that might be, even though we make everything as perfect as possible, and it happens. We need to know how to overcome some problems.
And you used, I see here, the same protocol that you first
screwed
the first three.
Exactly. And the same with the lower bridge. We just cement the anterior sleeves, and then we cement all the others in segments. Then we polish, we take out the bridge, we polish all the residues of the cement, because we want the zirconia to be clean. This is in the screw and restoration. One of the biggest benefits is that you don't have residue of cement, so you can take out the bridge immediately after the cementation. You can clean all the cement residues. You can close all the gaps, everything, make sure that everything is perfect, and then you cement the bridges, then you connect the bridges. You can see that the occlusion is nearly perfect. You have all the contacts on most of the teeth.
The screw channel here and on the canines, it's okay that it's in the front?
No, you need to close it with composite material in the color of the teeth, because the patient won't go with a yellow dot on the, it's probably old material. The picture was taken not in the same moment as screwed the bridge.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. We hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow us to stay tuned with the newest cases. Have a great day.